Since the creation of the Chamber, we have been connecting people, empowering entrepreneurial spirit, and elevating this great area as an ideal destination. An amazing destination for study, for living, for employment, and of course, for doing business.
Canterbury Bankstown Chamber of Commerce is making such a huge difference, not just to this region, but to New South Wales. Wally Mahana, to you and your board, congratulations, and what you have started here is simply incredible. And on behalf of the people of New South Wales, I want to urge you to keep going, keep going. Can I say, what we have in this room is a microcosm, an example of what we want to transplant in all parts of New South Wales. And I tell you why it's special. You have government working together by building metro, hospitals and roads, with the local community, the business community, who are building and preparing the future like never before. But I cannot tell you, as the Premier of this state, how proud it makes me feel when we see so many leaders in business and community coming together in this way. Not only will you be the gateway to the West, but you already are a success story.
Can I say to all of you who are part of this wonderful chamber, you came together only a few years ago, but you've been able to achieve so much for this area. And that is because of your commitment, your passion, your dedication, your belief in business, your belief in this community.
Okay, we're here tonight, right, for the Canterbury Bankstown Chamber of Commerce. This is an annual event each year, and every year it's getting bigger and bigger. And tonight, as we can see here, great guests, a lot of business people here today, and I've got a nice bunch of people here today.
My name is Shada, and I work for Regis. Okay. And we're here, all the Regis team.
All from the
Regis team? Yeah, Regis team and a few guests.
Yes.
And we're a member of the Chamber of Commerce.
What is your strategy on getting people to utilise your service?
I would say local area marketing.
Okay.
And that's
you look after marketing?
Well, I look after operations, okay. And Alana here looks after sales. So we, you know, work all around Sydney. But I'd say local area marketing is a very popular way to get businesses engaged.
Okay.
Because everybody needs an office.
Hi, my name's Cameron Lloyd. I'm the sales director for IWG. You know, we entered the market here and you know, our client bases are all small, medium, and large enterprises, yes. So it's a good fit for us.
Okay, so what we
intend to do is create a great day at work,
yep.
And we do that by delivering great spaces that people can come and conduct their business in, and really feel like you know they're coming home every day.
Yeah. Okay, Omar from Examine Property, an expert at property, and this is the second time we've seen him at the Canterbury Bankstown Chamber of Commerce. How are you doing today, Omar?
Yeah, doing really well, Davey. Yeah.
So one word of advice for, especially to our audience out there regarding business, is there a one or two strategy that you can perhaps impart on to our entrepreneur audience out there in terms of business or property?
I think marketing, networking is very big. Social media is a big thing these days. So my suggestion is get out there, meet as many people as you can. And get yourself out there networking and, you know, making connections with other businesses.
For that, folks, we've actually got Gus here from Liverpool Chamber of Commerce. Welcome to Canterbury Bankstown Chambers. How are you doing
Liverpool
today?
Liverpool Council. I'm well, thank you. Yeah. It's always great to come to a place where business people are there, because you can actually learn a lot with that and then equally try to pitch your ambitions there. So it's always great to see these wonderful ladies here.
Yeah. You're surrounded by two gorgeous models here with you, you know. Wow, you're in capable hands.
And I'm a humble bugger.
Ladies, are you planning to party tonight?
Definitely, a network. There's a lot of very interesting people, business owners. And it's very important that we promote small business in New South Wales. And this is a fantastic chamber for people to have some fun, network,
Having fun is
having
good.
Having some fun, yeah. And meet some lovely people, inspiring people. Yeah.
Wendy Lindsay, and she's actually new. How are you coping with politics so far?
Oh, look, you know, I'm starting to learn the ropes and I'm getting there. It's been a very busy more than 6 months now. So, yeah, I've been out a lot and met a lot of new people, lots of great people in the electorate of East Hills and beyond. So it's been fantastic.
How's your journey so far in terms of the community and the business side of things?
Well, look, you know, obviously I come from community radio, so I had many connections to the local community with a range of different ethnic groups as well as religious groups, and also just diverse, you know, English broadcasting that we did, different age groups. And as far as the business aspect goes, you know, my husband's an electrician, so he comes from small business. My parents were always small business owners, so, you know, I can empathise with the struggles that some small businesses do have, and, you know, being there to assist in any way I can in this new role as the member, because we do have a lot of advanced manufacturing in the East Hills electorate. So,
and it's really good to see that someone have the experience and the passion and heart to serve this community. I think you're a different woman to do that, right?
Oh, well, thank you very much for that. Look, you know, I do genuinely care about the people in my area. I mean, I've lived in this area all my life. I have travelled and I have lived overseas. It's always great to have come back. You know, I moved away one suburb from where I grew up, so East Hills is a fantastic place to live and I love it.
Fantastic. Enjoy your night. See okay, you we got here one of the chamber members here, Philip. And Philip's been a great supporter of the chamber. He's been around for such a long time and so passionate about this area. Philip, how are you feeling tonight, mate?
Very excited about tonight. It's our third year in and very passionate with everyone here tonight. Great networking event. I call it connecting.
Yeah.
We look at their concerns, their challenges, and we work together as family.
Yeah. We've had Tanya Mihalik here, a member from Bankstown, and she's actually been around here for such a long time. I would say she's like the veteran of the Bankstown area. What's your thoughts on that,
Thank
Tanya?
You. Well, I don't know if I'm a veteran, but I am someone who grew up here in Bankstown, and I love calling this place home. And I'm really proud of the businesses that we have here. And the growth that's happened around Bankstown is absolutely fantastic.
Your thoughts on Wally, Canterbury Bankstown Chamber. What's your thoughts on their journey and their story?
I have to say, I've spoken about Wally in Parliament and I have highlighted that he's really made this into a fantastic organisation. We didn't have a Chamber of Commerce in Bankstown. We haven't had one for many decades. He's been able to really bring businesses from across the entire network together and provide them a platform to actually showcase our region.
So from a political point of view, you must be so proud of Bankstown because we've got a large groups of multicultural community, but also a large group of entrepreneurs. What's your thoughts on that?
Well, it's interesting you say that because we do have a large number of people that have got great business skills.
Yeah.
And we've got innovative ideas coming from this region. And I think Bankstown really is a place to watch for the future. So I'm really proud of our businesses in this area. I'm proud of our young people in particular who are giving it a go. Okay. And I'm really proud of the fact that this Chamber of Commerce under the stewardship of Wally Mahana has just grown from strength to strength.
What's your, I guess tonight is here tonight to network and collaborate and make more connection? Is that the reason why you're here tonight?
Yeah, I think so, and it's really nice to see lots of new faces here tonight. I haven't seen a lot of these faces before, so nice to make connections with new people.
Yeah, same for our local business. We try to communicate and get to know as many people as possible, and events like this make it easy.
Peter, you're a director of the Liverpool Golf Club. I mean, how in terms of networking and collaborating, what's your view on tonight's event?
Well, I mean, networking is always important in our industry. We've got to get the word out about our business, and we obviously want to see more people come and visit our venue. But at the same time, don't forget there's a great charity event on tonight as well, and I think we need to pay tribute to that. It'll be worthwhile, and we all need to dig deep and support these great charities. So. What a night.